today now I'll write the code. My program is one server and different clients. So first five clients will be enter the number to the send the number to the server, and server will be finally calculate these five numbers and send to the client. Okay, then sixth number client will be display the result. Okay, so now I'll write the program, you just watch it. So I don't want to waste your time, so I'll write the speed of my code. So has include, I'll write the suppose server multi dot c. okay, inside I'll write server multi dot c, then also same itself also write okay gedit, okay, then client multi dot c. okay, so both side I have opened the file. Okay, then press the save. Okay, so here first I'll open the file, first I'll write all the codes. Okay, has include, okay, stdio.h, then has include, okay, I'll write stdlib.h, then I'll write has include, okay, I'll write string.h. These header files are used for C. Okay, now I'll be write the socket programming. Okay, what are the header files required for the socket programming? Has include, okay, I'll be write sys socket.h. okay, next I'll write has include, okay, then I'll be write sys, okay, types sys types.h, and has include, okay, orpa/inet.h, then next write has include, okay, net/inet/ip.h, right, has include, okay, or net/in.h, then has include, okay, unistd.h. okay, these header files you will be write for the purpose of run the socket program. So here will declare int main. Basically I want to do this program by using your what TCP socket program. So what will write int, I'll write server fd, and tell you, if you don't know what is the TCP socket programming or what is the UDP basic, I have given the link in the description box, you can see also there. Okay, so int server fd is equal to what to write. I'll be write socket means what? Socket is a interface between two devices. So we'll write if inet, okay, if inet interface, it is a protocol family, and then though it is a socket TCP socket, so here write sock stream. Sock stream means it is a TCP socket. Okay, so I'll be pass the protocol which is so sweet for the TCP socket. So here write IP proto underscore TCP. Okay, then what will do, I'll be check the error condition whether my socket is successfully created or not. So you'll write if, okay, server fd equals to -1, then what will write here, now p error, okay, socket creation failed, socket creation failed. Okay, then failed FILED. Okay, then slash. Okay, so then I'll be close my program here, don't go hide. So here I'll be close the program. Okay, then I'll be declare the internal structure. How to declare? We'll write stock, okay, sock addr underscore in. Okay, what to write? I'll be declare server and then so client. Okay, then what will write? Server dot scene family. What are the family of the server? I'll be write, okay, what now, af underscore inet. Okay, then what is the server dot scene @ADTR @s_ADTR is equal to, I'll be direct, also write the @ADTR_NE. It will automatically assign the IP address, but don't do this. I'll be write INET_ADTR. I'll be give the explicit IP address 127.0.0.1. This is the loopback address. Okay, then I'll be write server.syn port. What is the port number of the this is server? Then I'll be mention, okay, HTONS, host to network short. Here write the support 5000. Okay, so this is the card. Okay, this is the my server structure is ready. So now what will we do? I'll be declare INT OPT. Whenever I do the program, I'll be always find the binding error, so that for this port to avoid that binding error, I here use the one function that is called what? Now your sort set sock OPT, set sock OPT, you will be right. Okay, server FD, then here will write, okay, SOL. Right, socket. Then we'll be right. Okay. SO reuse ADTR. Reuse ADTR. Then we'll be right. %OPT. Okay. %OPT. Then we'll be right. Size of OPT. Okay, then till that I'll be check whether my coding is successful or not. So here I'll be close this, then I'll be compile this. Okay, then this much code is running properly. Then what I'll be do, I'll be here declare the bind function int b is equal to, I'll be write bind, okay, server fd. Okay, then I'll be right, okay, stock, sock, ADTR, okay, pointer, then I'll write %server, I want to bind with server, so, and here write the size of server, okay, size of server, then I'll be give the bracket close, okay, then two brackets will be there, okay, then here I'll sort of check the condition, whether bind failed or not, if b equal to -1, then here I can write B error, okay, bind failure, okay, then close the bracket and here I write the exit, okay, 0, okay, then what will do, here I will declare the listen function, okay, listen function, how many number of client can be connected simultaneously, here I will write server FD, okay, here I will write, okay, 5, that means 5 is the backlog, okay, that means at least 5 clients can connected to the system, okay, then what will do, I'll be, okay, here declare one variable, suppose int l is equal to this, okay, here write if, okay, l equal to 0, then server is ready, printf will write server, okay, is ready to listen the port. Okay, then I'll give the semicolon, then bracket close. Okay, then after what will write? I have told you, though it is a multi-server, multi-client program, so you need to put the accept function, okay, inside the while loop, so that while will be infinitely accept the this. But remember, I want to accept the 5 number of values. So here, I'll be declare the array that is called int arr. Okay, 5. 5 means it will accept the 5 value. And I'll for that, I'll be use index. Index is I. I suppose here I'll give the 0. Okay, int arr 5, then I equals to 0. But then I'll also again declare the sum. Sum is equal to 0, so that first time initially sum contains the 0, I index starts from the 0. So what will I write? then here I'll be right. Okay, while I'll be right one. Okay, while one. So spelling is a mistake there. So here, okay, I'll be first close the two bracket. Then what will write here? Now I will be right int client fd, because client whenever accept function always returns one fd, that is a client fd, and that will be used to communicate with the server. So what will write? Will be pass server fd. Okay, then remember one thing here, I'll be right, suppose int suppose length is equal to size of server or size of client, because access function returns the client information. So here we'll write int client fd equal server fd. Then same thing will write struct sock addr. Okay, then we'll write the pointer. Okay, we'll write ampersand. Okay, I will write ampersand client. Okay, client. Then we'll write size of, sorry, ampersand length. Length, it will be returns the length of the client. Okay, here also maintain the error code client fd equals to minus one. Then what to write? Now p error. Okay, we'll write socket accept fail. Okay. So here we'll be close the bracket. Then we'll write exit. Okay, zero. Okay, I think you'll be understood it. Okay, then exit zero. First thing, I'll be run after this much code, and I'll check whether my code is running or not. If it is not accept fail, then I want to display the information. Okay, then I want to display the information of the client. So what will write here? Will be right, okay, printf right, percentage s request from client. Comes from client. Okay, so here we get the slash n. Okay, then what to write? You will write inet. Okay, inet underscore ntoa, network to ASCII. Here write, okay, client dot scene underscore addr. Okay, then you close the bracket. Then I'll be run after this much of code and check whether it is successful running or not. You just see what. It will be displayed the error. That error is the what? Now client fd don't declare. Okay, so why client fd don't declare? I'll check here. You just see where client fd is the, I think same mistake is the there, server fd. Okay, then what will two things will be do here? Here write int client fd equals to accept. So I have forgotten to write this code. Then you check whether it is running or not. Okay, this is running. Then what to write? Now server fd stock socket ddr server, then size of server bind. Okay, then I'll check the what is the two error bind why this is the error. Then total id b is equal to bind. Okay, server fd stock. Okay, I am missing the bracket, so here given the another bracket. Okay, so in the speed writing mode I have do the errors. I am doing the error. So now it is running. So what I'll do, I'll be save the time. So what I'll do, I'll be same thing here will be copy and paste in the client side, and minor modifications are be there. So here then I'll paste the screen. Okay, you remember no need to write the okay, then up to I'll be here modify. Okay, so what will be the client side, no need to declare the array. So here I'll be remove the array. Okay, because array is required in the server side to store permitted data. So instead of server FD, I'll be right here. It is a client side client FD. Okay, so all the things are same. So instead of server FD, I'll be write the client. This is the client program. Okay, then server creation, then structure I have declared. And remember, the client side, no one required to declare the client variable. Okay, then declare same int op, though it is not writing the binding, so these two lines will be disconnected. So what will do, I'll be, instead of disconnect this line, I'll be converted into, okay, I'll be converted into what, now connect function. Connect function means it is written in client side to connect to the server. So here I have the connect function. If c equals to if c equals to minus 1, then you can find connection error. So here write the client FD. Okay, you write the client FD. Okay, then listen side will be remove this. Okay, then while loop, these things will be removed. Then you can write simple. Okay, here you will be write printf. Okay, connected to client. Connected to client. Okay, then slash in. Okay, then close it. Okay, then I have to one thing I have to tell you. Okay, always use the CL reset function to automatically clear the screen. So you write system. Okay, will be write clear to clear the screen. Okay, same thing. You also first will compile this. Okay, I am checking whether it is compiled successfully or not. You see it. Okay, yes, it is compiled successfully. And this side also I will write the which function, clear function. Okay, so you write system which is exist inside stdlib.h. So here I'll write the clear. Okay, then you see, okay, compile, then I'll compile this code and also run. For running purpose, you'll write /8.out. Okay, then the server is ready to listen to code. Here I'll compile again /8.out. Then till this, my server is connected, my client is connected to the server. So I mistake the spelling. So here I write client. Okay, so then what I'll do? I'll do one thing. Here will be write first. You need to you'll be disconnect the client. Okay, because client is in active mode because the while loop is written. So here what we'll do, after this line you will be do one thing, you will be send, okay, send the ID. Okay, send the I means your I means your index. Okay, here you'll pass the send the index. What to write? Client FD. Okay, I'll be pass the ampersand I. Okay, I is the index. Then what to write? Now size of, you can write the size of I or 1. Okay, then you pass the 0. Okay, then you will be pass this code to the what, now client side. Okay, then you see, I'll be immediate send this code I variable. Okay, to the what, where, now client side. Okay, so I've told you logic already. So here what will do, here you will be accept the I value and check with the, my program is the 5 clients. So first I will write the here program's name. Okay, so that you will be better to understand. Okay, here what is the program name I will write. Okay, write a program to write a program in TCP. Okay, in TCP. Okay, server accept 5 number from different client. Okay, different client. Okay, different from 5 different client. 5 different client. Okay, and server will calculate the sum and send to the sixth client. Okay, this is my program. So what will do here? Okay, then I'll save this. Then here I'll track the index. Okay, just see what you write here. Connected here it will be in index INTIDX. Okay, IDX. What will you write here? Now, if you write receive. Okay, receive. Okay, what will write? Now, you will write client FD. Client FD. Okay, I'll write ampersand IDX. IDX means stands for index. Okay, then here write. Okay, here write what? Now size of okay IDX and then will pass the zero. Okay, IDX size of IDX, or you can write as a 4 integer size, then 0 is the protocol, is the flag. Okay, then here check if okay if IDX equals to what? Not equals to 2. If not equals to 0 1 2 0 1 2 3 4, then 5 here, give the 5, where 5 clients after 6 means index is the 5, so not equals to 5. Okay, then what will do? Now it will start the bracket. Okay, it will be send the number where to the client, to the server. So what will write here? Write okay int number. Okay, then you write printf enter number, enter the number. Okay, then you will write okay scanf percentile d okay ampersand number. Okay, then here what will do? Send this number. You write client fd. Okay, then ampersand no. Okay, then here write the size of no. Okay, then it will write the flag 0. Okay, then okay, if I try to receive the number, and okay, if I try to receive the number, if ID is not equal to 5, then it will be sent the number to the okay server. Okay, then what will do? Server will be return this. Okay. Then what will do here? What will do server? Now client. Okay. Then okay. Then here will write okay. If okay I not equal same kind will write here 5. Then what will do here? It will be receive the okay. It will be receive the okay array. So here write. Okay, now you write receive. Okay, write ampersand receive client ampersand. Okay, then ARRI. I have that receive the ARRI value. Okay, then size of okay. I can write here int. Okay, so flag is the 0. Okay, then here is sum is equal to okay sum plus. Sum equal to sum plus okay ARR I value. Okay, so it will be received. Okay, so sum will be received. Okay, else. Okay, then else what will do here? Else will be okay, will be what? Now it will be send the output to the send the output to the client. If ARI not equal to 5, then it will be retrieve the okay till I not equal 5, it will retrieve the value number from the client side, and it will be add with each other. Okay, then after if equals equal to 5, then what will happen? It will be send the result to the what in a client. Here write the send function. Okay, here write send else if. Else if I equals to okay 5. Okay, then what will do? Send will write client fd. Okay, client fd, then here write okay ampersand sum. Okay, then write the size of okay int. Okay, size of int, then we will pass the flag. Flag will be 0. Then after my program should be exit there, exit here. So then it will be exit. Okay, so this is the while loop and this is for the main function. Okay, so I'll be compile this program. Whether it's successfully compile or not, check. Yes, successfully compile. Okay. Then you go to the client side, you know, what will the client side also same thing I'll be write. Okay, what will write? If it is 5, then go to else. In the else part, what will write? Else part, same thing I'll be write. Okay, receive. Okay, you'll be write. Okay, receive. Okay, now is here side, so we'll write the sum. Here I will declare the sum. Okay, sum is not declared. Yes, sum is declared already. So here, what will write here? Receive. Okay, you write client FD. Okay, then you write the ampersand sum. Okay, then write the size of sum. Okay, then we write the flag 0. Okay, then what will do? It will here write printf sum of sum of 5 client number, 5 client value is percentile d slash n. Okay, write the sum. Okay, then check whether it's successful doing or not. Else part, this is the main part. Okay, then another thing is there here. What will do happen now? You are taking the while loop, but still you are not writing I while I less than 10, I less than something, you are not written. So it will be infinite type. So your loop will be maybe hang or infinite type. So here what will do on outside the before close the while loop, here you write the I plus plus. That means I will be incremented by 1 by 1. Okay, so here I'll run the program. You just see. Okay, so here dot slash edit out. Then also same also here also this is it. Okay, then you check. Here enter the suppose 5, suppose 1. Okay, first client I send the value. Then after it will be disconnected automatically, but server is the active mode because it is written in while loop. So it will be wait, it will be not get close until unless 5 clients will be connected. Okay, so next time next client will be run. Okay, then you get from this, then suppose it will be enter the 2. Okay, then also then after it will be close. Then third client it will be access to 3. Then it will also close. Three clients already connected. Then 4 clients also it will be connected. Then 5 clients also enter the number. Okay, then 5 clients already send the value to the server. Now whenever 6th number client will be run, then we will check whether value is received from the server, the sum of 5 clients or not. Then we'll see here. Okay, then we run this program. Okay, then you can find. Okay, when after run this program, then you can find 5 clients, whatever value is given, 6th client does not know that, but after what the server will be calculate all these sums, okay, and totally find the sum and send to the 6th client. So then 6th client will display sum of 5 number is 15. So here will be do them some minor modification, then automatically server will also close. Then here I suppose I will write the here some modification. Possibly is requested from the client. Okay, so here will be make some minor changes. Request come from client. Request from client. Okay, request from client. I will be make minimize the code. Request from client. Okay, and here you can write the value. Okay, here write printf. Okay, percentage D client value is write percentage D plus N. Okay, here I can write I plus 1, that means that number of client. Okay, what is the value? I'll write here ARRI. Okay. So I think you enjoy this program. Okay, if you are new to my channel, then subscribe it. If you are already subscribed, then comment, like and share for getting this type of program. And I am to tell you again, it is not a tutorial lecture channel. It is a fully total entertainment channel. So don't bore about this channel. And also, I am to tell you, all peoples are, all students, all friends are asking me to get the code. But after I made this program, I deleted this code because it is a tedious task to send individually to the people. So I deleted. So don't ask me the code. You better you open this program, and I have written one by one line code, and you just write in the copy and make a habit of the program so that it will be better for you. If you are asking coding, then I will send this code. Then what will happen? You will be only copy paste and forget whatever you have written. So you always try to write the program and always learn the program from my video, and I have written one by one step. You just read one by one line and write in the copy and make a habit of the program. Okay, so here I do the slash editor, then here also, okay, then same program. Okay, client 1 connected. Suppose here IT 1, then you can find 1 client, value is 1. Okay, then again side, then suppose here 2, then second client, value is 2. Okay, suppose you like 7, then third client, value is 7. Okay, then they must suppose as 4, then 4th client, value is 4, then so 5th client, I have entered 10, then you can sign 5th client, value is 10. Okay, then when I will be writing dots are set out, you can find when the 6th client value is what, total 24, I think you have understood properly, and go back to the theory session. Okay.